Greetings, greetings, one and all.
Does that include me, Bing?
You were included very large, Rosie, and greetings from Norcross greeting cards, too.
Of course.
Friends, Rosemary and I have some things cooking here, which we hope will keep you reasonably enchanted for the next 20 minutes.
Well, at least we won't disenchant you.
Well, I hope not.
I lead off, don't I, chum?
That's the plan.
It's wonderful. It's marvelous. You should care for me. It's awful nice. It's paradise. It's what I love to see. You've made my life so glamorous. You can't blame me for feeling amorous. It's wonderful. It's marvelous that you should care for me.
Rosie, dear girl, have you checked my new spring suit? Don't you think it's chic?
Stunning. I've always loved that shade of red.
Oh, and you'll notice, too, that it's exactly the shade of the Norcross American Beauty greeting card rose.
Clever.
Oh, I like to keep in style. After all, you know, this is the year of the Norcross roses.
I know. And these new Norcross greeting card roses are the most handsome and stylish things in a month of birthdays.
Quite, quite, yes. From the Rosa Bellissima to the Rosa Stellata. From the mint beauty to the bronze beauty, there's a Norcross greeting card rose to match the mood of any friend or to garland any occasion.
Really? There are enough Norcross greeting card roses to fill a greenhouse.
Or to deck out a Derby winner, for instance. Orange beauty, burgundy beauty, rose parfait, or whichever. These new Norcross greeting card roses are indeed a delight to send as well as receive.
So, pick the card with the N on the back. N for Norcross, and send a friend a Norcross greeting card rose.
Truly, truly, Norcross greeting cards say the things you want to say.
And say them with one perfect rose. And Bing, I think your spring suit is lovely.
I thank you, Rosie. I'm grateful.
And it goes so well with your T-shirt, with the N on the back.
Come on along and listen to Lullaby Broadway. Hip, hooray, ballyhoo, that's the lullaby of Broadway. The rumble of a subway train, the rattle of the taxis, the daffodils who entertain at Angelo's and Max's. When Broadway baby says goodnight, it's early in the morning. Manhattan babies don't sleep tight until the dawn. Milkman's on his way. Sleep tight, my pretty baby. Sleep tight, let's call it a day. Hey, come on along and listen to Lullaby Broadway. The hidey-ho and boop-a-doo, Lullaby Broadway.
Band begins to go to town. Everyone goes crazy. You rock by your baby round till everything gets hazy. Hush, I'll buy you this and that. You hear a daddy say, and baby goes home to her flat. Gonna sleep all day. Good night, good night, baby. Good night. Well, the milkman's on his way. Want you to sleep tight. Call it a day. Listen to the lullaby of old Broadway.
Pleasantest way we know of to wash dishes is with Gentle Fells. It's the only dishwashing detergent with lanolin D to protect and keep your hands soft and lovely. And one capful of this clear golden liquid makes a sink full of luxurious suds. Gentle Fells pampers your hands while it washes your dishes. For a spotless reputation, Gentle Fells, F-E-L-S, Fells.
Rosemary, may I tell you that it's wonderful to have you here on the show and brighten things up with your radiant personality.
And do half the work?
Yeah, that's what I mean.
Mm-hmm.
But also brighten things up.
We can't call this work, Bing.
You're so right, Rosie, really. Singing is a joy.
Right you are. Say, you don't happen to be in a sentimental mood by any chance, do you?
Always.
Well, then let's sing something to remember you by.
I'm game.
Something to remember you by. When you are far away from me, dear.
Some little something, meaning love cannot die.
Night and day for you, it will see me through like a charm till you're returning. So give me something to remember you by. When you are far away from me, day for you, it will see me through like a charm till you're returning. So give me something to remember you by. When you are far away,
you know, during a leap year, such as we're in, a free male is apt to be snagged by a female at any moment. So as long as the single men are up for grabs, I think they should heed the following pointers. These are just little unsolicited items that I think will be helpful. I have a matrimonial rating here for women that I think that you could take advantage of. This rating has been worked out by a professor at the University of Louisville. His name is Professor John Scott Long. So now, if any of you fellas get bitten by the love bug, check this list and see if the girl stacks up. See how she qualifies. Here are the percentages, the way the good professor has worked them out. A young lady gets 40% for physical attractiveness. I agree on that. 15% for cooking ability. And, of course, this means knowing the proper foods, not just knowing how to dish them up. And she also gets 15% for health and 10% for similarity of interest with yours. That's important, very important, such as music, religion, stamp collecting, or whatever. Her skill with money is worth 15%. A good professor adds, he says, you make it, she spends it. We might get a little beef from the girls there. Sewing ability is good for 5%. Providing the girl hasn't skipped the critical lesson, that's buttonholing. As far as I'm concerned, they just got to know how to sew a button on. I'd make that a higher percentage, I think. Or is it too much to ask for them to sew a button on now and then? And there's another thing. The professor says men should be careful of marrying wonderful cooks. Should be real careful, because he claims they're killing their husbands with too much starch. Anyhow, those are the percentages from a scholarly gent in Louisville, so you just think things over, men, before taking the big leap. But wait a minute here. What are we talking about? When the love bug bites you, who's thinking? Anyway, Rosemary's moving in here now to ease me out of this little contretemps that I've caught myself in. It's all yours, Rose.
There's just one place for me near you. It's like heaven to be near you. Times when we're apart, I can't face my heart. Say you'll never stray more than just two lips away. If my hours could be spent near you, I'd be more than content near you. Make my life worthwhile by telling me that I'll spend the rest of my days near you.
Did you ever get mad at your boudoir lamp because it wouldn't take a 100-watt bulb? Well, the General Electric Company has outwitted those pesky little lamps. They've made a brand new 100-watt bulb that's as small as a 60-watt, but gives more than twice the light. And what's more, you can get these new small 100-watt GE bulbs in beautiful GE soft white that's flattering to your complexion and cuts out harsh glare and shadows, too.
Very nice, Buddy and boys. That thing moved nicely, didn't it, Rosie?
Oh, it sure did. Now I wonder if we could persuade Mr. Crosby to get to work.
Yeah, will you chirp something for us, Bing?
Oh, I certainly will. For this type of work, I need very little urging.
I found my love in Avalon beside the bay. I left my love in Avalon and I sailed far away. I dream of her and Avalon from dusk till dawn. And so I think I'll travel on to Avalon.
Cutting out now. Got to fade. Skip. Thank you very much.
Hope you listen again, friends.